Connected cars are once again a hot topic here at CES. But for 2014, we're getting even more connectivity into the vehicle themselves. This is Chevy's new OnStar 4G LTE service, and they're doing this in tandem with AT&T. And basically what it does is it puts a 4G radio directly into the vehicle itself, so you don't have to use your phone's Wi-Fi or data service, rather, to get Wi-Fi into your vehicle. Inside, as I said, there's a 4G LTE chip, and what it does is it allows you to access any number of apps that are automatically stored on the system. And alongside the OnStar 4G LTE, Chevy is also launching their MyLink app market. So you can see we have the apps up here. The marketplace isn't running right now because we're indoors and the connectivity isn't exactly great right now. But we can run you through some of the apps that are available, and the ones that we're launching with the vehicles will be obviously TuneIn, Vehicle Health Monitor, Priceline, Glimpse, Weather.com, iHeartRadio, NPR, and then we have a few more over here in Slacker, Kaliki, Event Seeker, and City Seeker. So just to show you kind of the quality of the apps that we're working with here, we want to jump to the Weather Channel, which is actually one of our favorites from the way that it actually looks. All the buttons are nice and large. It makes it easier so that when you're driving, you won't have to look down, you know, and search for buttons. Again, the connectivity is a little bit slow right now, despite being on LTE, because we're indoors in a large facility. So it's pulling up the forecast right now for Nevada, and you can see everything is just very clean, very pretty. You can see these little buttons up here for speech. What that'll do is it'll read the forecast to you. We can also check out the forecast for the day, and what that'll do is also pull up, it'll pull up a display of your area and give you a Doppler radar. So if we were in an area that actually had weather, unlike Las Vegas, we would be seeing different colors all over the place to indicate that there's some kind of precipitation. We can also go up here, check our location, and kind of, you know, do our destination, the destination that we're headed to, or a different location. We'll go back over here. I'm just, again, showing you around to give you an idea of how everything looks very nice and clean and very easy to use. We're going to back out, though, by pressing that, and we'll show you we have iHeartRadio down here. And again, it's a standard iHeartRadio app that you're used to, but it's, once again, very clean. You can actually log in to your iHeartRadio account because the app is stored here. It doesn't run off your phone, and it'll pull down your data from the cloud. So any stations that you like will be automatically populated on the car itself. You can see, again, large buttons, very easy to navigate. We have Bruno Mars running right now. We'll exit out. And what's cool is when you press the quit button, it actually asks you if you're sure you want to quit because, you know, if you happen to press now playing and accidentally quit, it's going to be a pain. We can go over here, and we have Slacker. Kaliki is actually a service that lets you, will read news to you from any number of stations. So right now, it's loading up. Before we were running 60 Minutes, we were listening to the newscast on 60 Minutes. You can check the weather right away. If you don't want to check the Weather Channel, it'll read everything to you. It's going to pull up our recent selections, which should include CBS Radio. And you can just kind of click in, and it'll give you exactly what you want, an hourly newscast. And it will read everything to you out loud over the stereo system. We're just going to X out, back out ourselves. And City Seeker and Event Seeker are basically things that allow you to find interesting things to do in the town that you're in. So if you're driving to a new city, you just click Event Seeker, and it'll pull down the data from, again, the LTE connection, finding the location that you are, and pull up a million different events. And we're in Las Vegas right now, so it's gonna give us everything that you can think of. Click nearby. And again, a very nice, easy to navigate interface. We have comedy clubs, different things going on all over the place, Bally's, different casinos. So it's a lot of different things that you can do in the area. So beyond the City Seeker app, we wanna just back out again and talk to you about the AT&T connectivity. Again, the 4G radio is built into here, and what you're gonna be able to do is pair this with your mobile share account if you're an AT&T customer. So the car will actually be treated as basically another cell phone on your account or a tablet. Now, what's interesting with what AT&T is doing with OnStar is that you get to use this as a hotspot, but based on what we're hearing so far, the charges won't reflect that. So it'll just be a standard connection. You won't have to pay extra for using it as a hotspot. And you can use this to connect to up to 7 different devices. So that's actually a really big benefit and something that will keep people wanting to come and use this in their vehicle. So again, this is the 4G OnStar with 4G LTE and Chevy's MyLink app shop. And we're checking it out here at Showstoppers at CES 2014, and I'm Dan Howley with Laptop Magazine.